Welcome back to the show where things are going to be a little different from now on. Hello, Rob, how are you?
I'm good, mate. You all right?
I'm not too bad. We are having a little bit of a change up, aren't we? We have changed the format of the show. We've listened to a few opinions that are coming on social media. So
we're now a Minecraft podcast.
Yeah, we're now streamcast. I'm just going to shout into my microphone really loudly. We're going to try and make it a little bit more like a drive time show. So we're going to have our conversations. We're not going to have a really fixed sort of ABC all the way to Z. It will just be interchangeable sections when we choose to put them in. So don't expect it all to run in exactly the same way the other episodes have. So it's not going to always go, do you remember, then into taste test, then into nostalgic kids knockout, then into our conversation. It's just going to be all over the place. It's just going to be a bit more relaxed, a little bit shorter, which I think we've both agreed 2 hours every time might be a little bit too much.
Yeah, quite long.
Excuse the coughing, by the way. I've got one of those annoying tickly coughs. I hate it. It'll last a month. It will not go away for a month now. It just sounds like I'm laughing at everything.
Yeah, I had one of those at the start of the year. It just kept going and going.
Doesn't it? It just keeps going and going. And I hate it. I really... And it keeps the kids away. And T hates it as well. He hates anyone coughing. He runs over and hugs me when someone coughs really loudly next to him.
What about when you cough?
He seems to be okay when I cough. But when Jem coughs, he hates it. He really, really hates it. And he comes and runs and kind of cuddles up to me. It's like, oh, Bubba, it's only a cough, but just obviously a little bit of a trigger for him. I don't know, but there you go.
How old is he now?
He's two.
So you get a couple of weeks ago. The personality's coming too. Of course, yeah, it's birthday.
Oh, God, the personality came and it's not going anywhere.
Because with my tea, the terrible twos, you know, air quotes, hit us like a fucking truck. Such a lovely, innocent little boy he was. Wallop. He's still a lovely and innocent boy.
Oh, absolutely he is.
But, yeah, those tantrums, wow.
We're not having too many of those yet. Touch wood, and I am touching wood because I know they're coming.
Yeah.
They're unavoidable, so...
How was Kay with them?
I don't really know, you know. I wasn't really about at that point, so I don't know fully how she was. I'd expect just like any little child, any toddler really at the age of two. So it's unavoidable, isn't it? No matter how the temperament of the child, from what I've read, the terrible twos just hitting, and it's about pushing boundaries and all that stuff, isn't it?
I just get told off a lot. He tells me off all the time.
Yeah, and they discover their favourite word is no, even when they mean yes.
Oh, absolutely. It's...
Would you like some dinner? No. And then screams at you because they're hungry.
Exactly. They just don't know. They get to the point I always say about T is that he doesn't know what he wants. I would go to him and say, you don't know what you want. I know what you want because you're like this when you need this. So let me give you this.
It has been 3 hours since you've eaten something.
Yeah.
You are going to be hungry.
Yeah.
That is nature, child. You will learn this.
We get this great one. So where the way our living space is at the moment, we've got this tiny little sofa all the way at the end. I'll have to send a picture so you can understand And I'll be there in the kitchen with the other side of it. And I'm like, what do you want for breakfast? I shout to him. It's normally he wants a brioche or something. It's what he normally wants. But he'll go, ice cream, like that. And I'm like, no, you can't have ice cream. And then you'll see his little head will poke up from behind the sofa and he'll have the biggest grin on his face. He'll be going, ice cream. It's like, no. And then sometimes he'll get upset. Other times he'll go, brioche.
Love it. Someone's obviously taught him breakfast and ice cream is A-OK.
I make him milkshakes.
Nice.
Which is basically just ice cream and milk.
Absolutely.
And
cheapest ice cream as well. It can't be expensive.
Oh, it's just Sainsbury's own branded ice cream and it works totally fine.
It's the only ice cream that works. You can't use posh ice cream and milkshakes like that. It's got to be the cheapest, nastiest vanilla essence ice cream you can get.
Yeah, you just stir it up with a fork in the mug straight away and give it to any milkshake, off he goes. So I do get that as well. I get milkshake. No, you can't have milkshake for breakfast. Well, the thing we're doing at the moment is, sorry, this is turning into a dad episode already. We play these little games with each other where, you know, like it started off with I got your nose. The classic, right. I've got your nose. And then you eat it. That's what we do. And then he has to try and get out of your mouth. You run away or whatever. He does this thing where you turn the lights off at night. He goes, Daddy, I can't see my eyes. I can't see my eyes. And I, at the beginning, I was like, no one can see their eyes, D. And he was like, and then, so now we just both do it every night. And we turn the light off and go, I can't see my eyes. But now he pretends to eat your eyes.
Oh, my God.
So he grabs your eyes and goes, hump. And then you have to walk around the house, like, with your eyes closed. And I'll be going, like, but where do I go? Where do I go? And he'll point. Because obviously I've got a little bit of an eye open so I can see. That's... And I'll be like, you can't point, T, because I don't know where you're pointing. I've got no eyes, remember?
I've got to say, that's quite twisted.
And he's like, oh, yeah, oh, yeah. And then I'm like, can I have my eyes back now? And then what he did today was he pretended to put glue in my eyes and then put the eyes back in.
Nice.
We're very weird.
It's fine. We were watching the Addams Family Values earlier. Oh, yeah. And Kay loves it. It's one of her favourite films.
It's a great film.
And it's just that beginning bit where you've got baby Puber in the cot.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he's got your father's eyes. Gomez, take those out of his mouth.
Did I tell you what he did with the umbrella in the car last week?
No.
Maybe I didn't tell you. So it was raining and we were on our way to swimming.
Okay.
I take him on my own swimming. And he was in the back and I heard a whack, whack, whack. I looked round and he was whacking the window with the end of his umbrella. Like smacking it. And I went, excuse me, that's naughty. And he instantly stopped and he turned and looked me straight in the eye and went, I am not naughty. Like that. And I went, excuse me, insert name here. I didn't say you were naughty. I said what you were doing was naughty. And he went, Daddy? I was like, yeah. And he goes, you're naughty.
Good God.
And then he just dropped his umbrella. I was like, all right, okay. Sassy.
Try to work out who he takes after, you or Miranda.
Miranda's not like that.
Oh, so it's purely you.
It's got to be, take it from me. She isn't like that at all.
Yeah. Anyway, as we said, we are going to randomly play these episodes by ear and throw things in when they are. And one thing we've removed from the episode is the Star Trek.
Yes.
It's not gone. Don't panic. For those of you that did listen and enjoy the Star Trek side of things, we're moving that on to a separate podcast. It's still going to be under this podcast's name, and it's going to come out every other week. So when you've got an episode of this released on a Monday, the following Monday will be the Star Trek episode, and then it goes back onto then the next Monday will be a normal episode. So every 2 weeks, you'll still get one of these episodes, and every other week, you'll then get the Star Trek episode. If that makes sense.
I've got some hot takes on the nurse to talk about as well.
Oh, yes. Yeah, well, you can bring that up in the other episode. So, I was going through my guilty pleasures on my iPod. And, well, my iPod, iPhone, I should say.
Dusted off the iPod.
I miss my iPod, you know. I miss having something that all it could do was play music or videos. No one could interrupt me. It didn't just go ping, ping, you got a message. It was just all in one. Anyway.
The wild west of MP3 players and LimeWire and Kazaa.
Oh, yes.
SoulSeeker. Oh,
good old LimeWire.
And you'd spend like 25 minutes downloading something completely legally.
Of course.
And it would just be... Did you ever get those?
Yes, yes, yeah. I got those. And I got the ones that were immediately flagged up by, I think it would have been AVG-free at the time that I had installed.
Have I told you the story my dad did to me?
No.
Oh, he's terrible, my dad. I like to play tricks on people. My old man, he's sneaky with it. So we all know he's the gentleman rock star.
Of course he is, yes.
When he found out that I was downloading music, not that he really understood how I was doing it, but he knew I wasn't paying for it. A letter come through the post, and it was from it was some government agency. Have I told you this before?
You haven't told government me this, but I can see where it's going.
A perfectly styled letter sent to me, basically saying, we know what you're doing and you've been downloading this much data. You're being fined. And it was quite a large fine, a few £1,000 fine or something.
Yeah.
Unless I basically stop it. Well, I didn't open it. My mum did. And he never told my mum.
I came home
from college one day. Mum went absolutely mental at me, thinking that I was like in real trouble and I owed thousands of pounds to like Sony or some like, government agency.
Oh, that's wonderful.
And there's
wonderful.
My dad like in the moment going, laughing about it.
Oh, that's wonderful.
And it was a really good letter, like spot on. He had all of the images in the corners and stuff. Yeah.
Brilliant. Absolutely.
I didn't stop. I just
was
a bit more discreet.
Just a little bit more discreet.
Turn the volume down.
Love it. Okay, right. So I set a challenge to you to create a playlist of your top 10 guilty pleasures that were in your library of your music. Whether it's, you use Spotify, don't you?
I use Spotify.
So we've got an iTunes family account, which means we've got all of iTunes available to us. And my library has been growing exponentially. It's always, I'll hear a song and it's like, oh, I like that song. Add it to the library. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so your library kind of grows a little bit out of control, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I don't know. How well kept is your library? Is it a complete desolate kind of plane of everything under the sun? Or is it very, very fixed, only songs that you really
it's
like?
It's all over the place. So I do have... At one point, I kind of had... Spotify's a bit different, I guess. It's not how I used to do iTunes. I'd go and get an album and plunk it in. Mm-hmm. I don't really tend to do that. I normally get the artist and then save the artist radio, and it kind of just skips between their songs.
Yeah.
I have a playlist that I would add specific songs to. Rand and I do a family share on Spotify, so I can see kind of hers in your mind. But I haven't updated it in ages. There's some ancient stuff on there, which actually I don't... Because I've listened to it all to death. What I quite like that Spotify does is at the end of the year, it does your year.
Yeah, yeah.
And then
yeah.
All of your stuff will be in a playlist. So I've saved all of those.
That's really cool.
And that's what I tend to actually listen to. Or when if I want to go back to, I don't know, 2018 or something, I'll go, oh, I'll just listen to my 2018 playlist. And it will go on for like 100 songs. It'll just kind of go down in the list of how often you listen to them.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Which
I like
is really
that.
Neat. Yeah, I like doing that.
Oh, see, if I wasn't paying for iTunes, that would actually make me pay for Spotify, yeah. I think. Okay, well, no, anyway, guilty pleasures then. How bad were yours before? Don't even tell me what they are yet. How bad would you say yours are when, if you were asked in a pub by a group of your friends, what were your 10 guilty pleasure songs? How embarrassed by them would you
be? I wouldn't be embarrassed by any, because the songs that I like, people know what they are and rip it out of me all the time anyway.
Oh, fair enough.
So the embarrassment stage is long gone, and I've embraced my my music taste. I actually was talking to somebody on Twitter I needed to reply to, and it was about the singing episode of the show that shall not be named in this. And they were saying how they don't like musicals.
I saw the same post. Yeah. I'm not a fan of musicals normally, unless I go to West End and actually see it in person.
Yeah.
I won't watch them. I hated Matilda the musical. It just really wasn't my cup of tea. Mm. That episode, though, blew my mind. But, yeah.
Spoilers, I'm all about musicals.
But, yeah, so you're like me. You've got an eccentric music taste. I kind of grew up with 50s and 60s rock and roll, then went to secondary school and had the piss taken out of me for that. Then I started kind of finding my roots on other things I liked. So I had a secret loving for kind of pop music, but actually I got really into heavy metal. So I discovered Metallica, Drowning Pool, Slayer, yeah. Sepultura, all that sort of stuff.
I've not heard of that one. You could have put that in that quiz. Sepultura.
Sepultura, yep.
Sepultura. Does that mean something? Is that like an epidural?
I'm trying to remember where they are.
Where
if
did
they
the tube
were
go?
The Brazilian band or not. Actually, no, they weren't. Who was the Brazilian band? I think it was Brazilian band. God, no. It's going to really, really annoy me now.
Beaver Town.
I know the song. It's called Jump the Fuck Up by Soulfly. And that's a whole different genre
of
metal.
I'm looking at you completely blank.
The lead singer's guitar's only got four strings, of which one of them's a bass string.
Right. Isn't that like a ukulele's got four strings? Is that right?
Yeah, ukuleles have got four strings, but not one of them's a bass string. And they also don't sing very, very heavy metal with a ukulele.
Not death metal.
Although death metal ukulele. You might be onto something there.
Write that down.
Right. Guilty pleasures then. So yeah, so I went into heavy metal and then now I just listen to anything. If I like the beat, if I like the music, I'll listen to it. I don't care about being in a cliche anymore. A clique, that's the one, anymore. I just want to enjoy my music. So I'll listen to opera, German metal, you name it. I'll listen to it. And if I like it, I like it. But I will say, some of these songs out of my 10, even I struggle to...
I'm not embarrassed about any of mine. Some of mine are... just songs that I just really like. And I don't know if there's so much a guilty pleasure, but more just like songs I have to myself. One of them is literally on my music list that we did on the website.
Yeah, okay.
My songs on here.
Well, for me, these are definitely guilty pleasure because I kind of associate them with when I would listen to music without anyone else around, because then I knew I could just get on with enjoying them.
Well, that these are all those, definitely.
Fine.
I wouldn't be listening to any of these. Maybe actually that's a lie. The first two I'll mention, I would listen with them around. The other ones I would listen with.
Fine. Okay. So my very first one, I don't know. Should I play you the beginning bit and see if you can guess it?
Yeah, go on then. I'll play that game because I'm terrible at this.
Okay, so I don't know how well this will come over the mic, so I'll probably have to do some editing at some point. So here comes song number one.
I recognise it. Oh, it's N-Dubs. Yeah, of course.
It is good old N-Dubby Dubby Dubs. Number nine. Can you tell me the song, though?
Oh, of course I can't.
It was Strong Again by N-Dubs, that one.
So Dappy released a solo album, I think. One of his songs on his own is absolutely brilliant. I'll have to look up which one it is.
Okay.
Really good. We're talking, I'll look it up because it's genuinely very good.
Okay, fair enough. But as cheesy as most of their album was and terrible as most of their album was, there were a couple of songs they did I really liked. So, that's number one. Number two,
I'm pretty sure it's called Dappy No Regrets.
Okay. This next one, you're going to get within seconds. I can guarantee
you.
Go on.
Oh, yeah. Miranda was listening to this the other day, and I come in and I was like, what are you listening to IFL 65 for?
Why wouldn't you listen
and
to IFL 65?
She was like, it's just on a 90s playlist or whatever it was she was listening to. I was like,
oh, sad times. It is
against,
the 90s, isn't it?
I was like, I'm not against the song. I'm just like, this is an odd choice for you. This isn't a song I'd be listening to.
Yeah.
Not a song you'd be listening to. This nearly made my list.
Did it?
Yeah, it was going to be ones, but I just had ones to put
on. I love it. Jem's not that big a fan of it, and Kay just sings all the wrong words when it comes on in the car.
Do you remember Zorba's Dance?
No.
That lives in the same... That, there's a special section in my brain for IFL 65, Zorba's Dance. Those kind of Barbie, Aqua, any Aqua song, they all live in the same little section of my brain. I'm going to bring up Zorba's Dance for you where you tell me another one of your songs.
Okay, well, this is the next one. Let's see if you get this one. He's looking very blank at the moment. Say that again, sorry?
I recognise this as well.
Oh, you should do. It was a huge song.
I'm rubbish at these things.
Copyright strike. Yeah. That's the end of the show.
Oh, but is it Boyzone?
It is Boyzone. Well done, but what's the song?
That was my Ronan Keaton impression.
Nice.
I can't remember.
It's up there with the, what's the name of the song? That's the same impression that you do for Search for the Hero Inside of Yourself.
Yes.
Words was that song.
Words are all I have.
Right, moving on very quickly.
Can I just do Zorba's Dance quickly for you while we go too far? Remember that?
Ooh.
Yeah, that's the same place in my brain.
Okay. This next one, I'm sure you probably will know, but we'll see.
Rabbit. Oh, yeah. They're Tottenham fans.
Oh, of course, yes. Good old Chaz and Dave.
Chaz and Dave, that's it.
And what's the name of the song?
Ribbit, 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 ribbit.
So yeah, Rabbit, Chaz and Dave. It's a very weird one for my selection. But oh, absolutely. You can't kind of avoid. Right, this next one, I'm sure people will think I'm strange. If they don't already think I'm strange.
Well, I think you've passed that.
Probably.
It's a case, sirrah, sirrah. Yeah.
There you go. I am officially Ned Flanders. Going outside to sing as the meteorite heads towards the earth to kill us all. I don't know why. I've just got a very big soft spot for that song. And I'll quite happily sing it at the top of the voice.
Should I have got all these ready in my Spotify to play people?
You don't have to. We could do that another episode. You could do your 10 back to me in the next episode.
No, I think people will know mine.
Okay.
I don't think I'm ready to play.
Right. Very odd. Next one. We've already had a boy band. So obviously.
Spice Girls.
They're later.
Ah. Is it the Irish lot?
It's not the Irish lot.
You know which ones I mean, though.
Yeah, Bewitched.
I don't know who this is. TLC or something?
You don't know who Atomic Kitten are.
Oh, it's Atomic Kitten.
Or if you were putting it into some sort of quiz game where you could put the opposite name, what is Nuclear Pussy?
Atomic Kitten.
Yeah. Atomic Kitten. Yeah, again, it's in my library. I like it. I should highlight, these aren't songs I listen to every day.
Yeah, these will be on your 2023 Spotify rewind.
Okay, four more to go. Heading back, I think this one was 70s or 80s, this one. It's probably going to throw me wrong, and it'll probably be the 90s, but...
Well, it's going to be Royal Britannia. Again, I recognise it again. The West.
There we go. He gets it. Yep, Go West by Pet Shop Boys.
Yeah.
Banging tune. I love their Elvis cover of You Were Always On My Mind as well. Yeah. Oh, this fucking cough. I'm going to cry. Right, okay, three more to go. You're talking about the Spice Girls, or as Kay called them when she was really small, can we have the Spicy Girls, please?
Oh, this is one of their later ones.
It was, but it was
The video was the fairies. Because this is post-Ginger leaving.
What?
No, Posh leaving. One of them left. This is only four of them, I thought. Or it's the last one. Is this the Spice Girls one?
That is the Spice Girls.
I'm talking absolute bollocks. It's not the song I was thinking of.
It's Mama.
Yeah, it's not Mama. What's the one
Mama,
with the...
Mama, I love
Wait, is that the video that's got like the fairies in the forest? Isn't it like the last song they all sung together?
I don't know.
God, how is our...
The fact that Spice you know more about Spice Girls
I had Spice
videos.
Girls like all over my wall and everything. I love Spice Girls.
Yeah, but... What people don't want to ask is how that was stuck to the wall.
It's a pre-blue tack, yeah. I was a young man.
It's white tack, honest. I bet it is.
Dude, we've both got boys. We've got all this to come.
Oh, Jesus.
Hold the pun.
Don't bring that cum.
Hold the pun.
Okay, two more. This one might throw you a little bit.
Well, it starts like Queen.
It does start like Queen, because it is a Queen song.
Fuck, I know it. Who's covering Queen?
It is, with Queen, Five.
Whoa! That was five.
And it's one of those...
Father, get you get down now.
Exactly. Don't get me wrong. The original versions of any Queen song is better. Again, very soft spot for that version, though, well, because it's so hardcore 90s and early noughties.
It's so boy band. Did you like Blue?
Yes.
Yeah, they next?
I was working at Woolworths when... Blue kind of went big, and I remember getting the albums in, the singles in, and having kind of all, as I worked on the entertainment counter at the weekend, and having all the CD drawers, and you had loads of blue albums. Then we had the fold-up posters to give away with when the albums came in as well. And oh, it was...
I had a girlfriend whose email address started as Blue R Sexy.
No.
That was her email address, yeah.
Oh, dear.
Yeah.
Does the email address still exist? That's a question.
Probably.
Okay, final song. And I will say, actually, I don't particularly like this person. But her songs, annoyingly, every now and then, there's a couple that I like.
Madonna?
No, God, no, no.
Because she's a knob.
Oh, she is a knob. But no, no, it is.
Oh, it's, Oh So Quiet. Is it her?
Oh, I don't know.
Lily Allen. I love Lily Allen. No, I absolutely love Lily Allen.
So I'm just not a fan of her.
I love all of them.
I some of her songs I like, but her as a person I'm not fond of, I'll be honest. But no.
Well, her dad is...
Keith Allen.
Keith Allen, yeah. Or Vindaloo. Vindaloo.
Yes.
Yeah.
But anyway, I quite like that one.
They're all good. I've listened to all those,
or,
really.
It's Not Fair, or it was a toss-up between those two songs.
Yeah, It's Not Fair is a good one. Yeah,
it
yeah.
is a good one. I've never been that man. Let me just put it that way. Just put that out there.
So just remembering the lyrics.
Exactly. There we go.
It's not fair, and I think you're really mean. Yeah.
Laying in the wet patch.
Yeah.
delicious. So there you go. There were my 10.
Some reason, at the beginning of that, I thought it was Bjork. That's who I was getting at.
Oh,
instantly,
no,
I thought,
no.
Is that Bjork? And as soon as I actually listened to it properly, I was like, no.
So what did you think? What did you think of my top 10
I don't think,
guilty
well,
pleasures?
Okay, you do have a few embarrassing ones. If we're gonna, yeah, I wouldn't be sat in the pub with Mark and Dan telling them how I really liked Boyzone. Or
yeah, it's not going to be the one that you go to the pub and go, oh, look, they've got one of those awesome jukeboxes. You can look up any song and put any song
and
you
yeah,
want
and then
on.
You whack that on. But I would, yeah, I would talk about I Feel 65. Everyone likes I Feel 65.
Oh, how can you not like I'm Blue, dubba dibba da 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 ba da
bee. Do you remember the video?
Yes. The
literally
little
blue
bad
aliens.
CGI yeah. aliens.
It was great.
Yeah.
Absolutely brilliant.
Best time in music.
Let me tell you some wine.
Go on then.
I'll be
far away. Let's go for your 10, and then we'll have a look at maybe doing one of our.
The first three all categorizing actually into one, but I put them in three.
Okay.
And essentially, it's musicals. I love musicals. I'm going to name two musicals and the last episode of Star Trek.
Nice.
To personify what I like. So, the last episode of Star Trek.
Yeah, okay.
Well, not last time, but you know which one I mean, the music one.
Yeah.
No, whatever it was. Les Mis. I am obsessed with Les Mis.
Okay. I've never seen it.
So I had always wanted to see it, and then the film came out, and I watched the film and was like, this is incredible. And then I've gone to the theatre and seen it twice, maybe three times, I can't remember. And I've got like different versions on DVD, I've got Blu-ray, of all different ones
okay.
of different people. So it's like the main guys. So if you ever have you seen the film?
I've never seen any Les Mis.
Okay, well
I know the songs and they are very catchy.
They might know this when Hugh Jackman's character is stealing from the church right at the beginning. This isn't spoiler ridden. The pastor or the whatever he is, the priest,
yeah.
that actor is Jean Valjean from the original play.
Right.
Which is a really neat touch.
Okay.
Because, and his voice is incredible. Anyway, love that. And this is the embarrassing one that I get ripped all the time, High School Musical.
Oh, man.
The first one.
I'm not sure you can come back from that.
The first one, it's, I call it, the, me and a friend of mine, we call it the Highsicle Musical, just because we like to make wordplay.
But of course.
It, I don't know, it's just something about it. It's just so wholesome. Very America, very silly. Just, I don't know, just something about it. It normally would make me feel sick, but there's just something about that one film. I can't watch any of those kids' shows at all that are in the same vein as that.
Okay.
And, you know, the new one that they put on the high school, I keep saying that, the High School Musical TV show. That's a musical thing
Glee.
They did. Yeah, Glee the musical, whatever. All that stuff I hate. I don't
okay.
like any of that stuff because it's too fake.
Yeah, okay.
Whereas High School Musical did it first, in my eyes. Did it worked. Anything after that is copying and is shit.
Okay.
But other musicals, like I can't wait to watch the Barbie film because I know there's loads of singing in the Barbie film. I'm so looking forward to being able to
I will
watch.
Tell you, there is definitely in the Barbie film, you're going to love it for
yeah.
that those parts. And look up, there's an episode of South Park where They released it when High School Musical came out.
I think I've seen it.
And it's one of the funniest episodes.
But it's why I really like The Bigger, Longer, Uncut, because all the singing in it.
Oh, and that's just so such good.
After
such a good film.
You put that the song in one of our previous episodes.
Blame Canada.
Yeah, I would listen to the whole album. I love this. This is terrible. Sorry, don't cancel us. I really like the Saddam Hussein and Satan song.
Yeah. You know, one of my favourite albums is South Park, and it's the Chef Aid album.
Yeah.
And it is a brilliant album with so many good different... You've got punk on there, you've got Wycliffe Jean on there, you've got rock on there, you've got drum and bass. It's an amazing album.
Another thing about My Old Man Again, we listened to, for the first time, Suck on My Chocolate Salty Balls together. Can you imagine My Old Man listening to that on CD? Single?
Yeah, but I can't imagine him listening to Rammstein, and now I know he does.
Okay, right, next up, Meatloaf.
On that, no.
I don't think that's a guilty
pleasure.
That's
not a guilty pleasure at all.
But I listen to that, and the CD I have is my mum's CD because she's really into Meatloaf too. But
Bad Out of Hell, 2 out of 3 ain't bad.
Song of Madness is fantastic.
Yeah,
yeah, and so is Did You Ever Love Somebody? They're two songs I really love. They did Paradise by Dashboard Light is another. Fantastic,
I was just going to say Paradise.
Oh, gosh,
and I Would Do Anything.
Yeah,
you can't. They all Meatloaf. Full stop.
Yeah,
I wish I'd gone to see the Meatloaf musical.
I've got to say, like, I'm empathetic when people pass away and things, but there's something, when a famous person has died.
Yeah.
I've been like, okay, this famous person. The Meatloaf was the only one I was like, fuck.
Yeah, see, I was very much the same when Dimebag Darrell from Pantera died. He was shot on stage by a lunatic.
Yeah.
It was probably the first time out of any kind of musician or celebrity I'd gone, shit.
Right, here's one you've got to guess. Ready?
Oh, God, okay.
You'll get it.
Oh, God, I know that beginning. Oh, the JCB song.
Yeah.
That's just a nice song.
Nizloppy.
CB.
Yeah, Nizloppy. Somebody was singing that in Hemel Town a few weeks ago.
I've had that to my playlist library, actually. Because
such a nice song. I think... It hits a bit different as well when you're a dad. Those kind of songs like that. But yeah, brilliant. This one's great. It's a song called Husovic. And it's from the Eurovision movie.
I've not seen it. And I should do because I like Will Ferrell.
It's so good. Just hilarious songs. I like Eurovision. Brandon and I stay up and watch Eurovision.
Yeah.
And it's brilliant. I really want to have a Eurovision party where everyone picks from a hat their country and they have to vote. I really want to do something
when the
that
house
one.
Is done,
yeah.
Do it next
yeah,
year.
Yeah, I really want to do it. So hold on, you might get an invite to a Eurovision party. This is another one that is not embarrassing, not even slightly. Blue Oyster Cult, Don't Fear the Reaper.
No, amazing
I listen
song.
To it on my own. I sit on the thing, I windows down, I blare it out.
I've got to say, I think you've missed the point of guilty pleasures here because so far you have named amazing songs.
Well,
all but High School Musical.
Well, three. Meatloaf, you, Blue Oyster Cult.
No, but I think a lot of people would agree that the French Revolution would be not a guilty pleasure. I know people that would listen to that as an album on repeat if they could.
Yeah.
So, again, I'm not sure it falls under guilty pleasure.
Yeah,
but
I might have missed the point of it.
No, it's fine, but keep going.
I've got,
it's
only got two left because I miscounted. I've got 9, not 10.
Oh, well, go for it.
Longest Johns. Have you heard of them?
Not a clue.
They sing sea shanties.
Okay.
I like sea shanties.
Fine.
Yeah. They do a really good one. There's two I like. There's one called Santana and another one called Bones in the Ocean.
Right. Okay. Sea shanty is not a genre I am au fait with.
Yeah.
So, no, fair play.
Look it up. And then another one. This one is dangerous because they're Russian. So don't hate me, everybody. It's a band called Little Big.
Never heard of them.
And there's like three songs I want everyone to listen to.
So as soon as you said Russian, I'm starting to think, okay, is it all whatever that band was that did all the things she said?
No, not those two lesbians.
Tattoo, that was
Tattoo,
it.
Tattoo, no. two lesbians, those two girls, who I think were lesbians, they might not have been. But that was how they were sold to everyone, wasn't it?
I'm pretty sure,
there's two young, attractive girls. They're lesbians. You'll like them more.
Nice
save. Sorry?
Nice save.
Yeah, thanks, yeah. I realised how I was like, just making it sound like I'm a terrible person. This band might have been the Russian entry once. This is not how they were famous. The Russian entry once into Eurovision, the last time that they might have been in Eurovision.
Right.
But it's their videos that really sell their songs. So there's a song called Skibbity. Yeah, I'm going to play it for you.
Go on, yeah. I think.
And there's one called Go Bananas. And then there's, do you remember I told you the lyric to one of the songs? Is my dick is as big
No, it's not these
ones. Yeah, that
one's
called Big Dick.
I mean.
And that goes, my dick is big, my dick is very big. And then it has a girl who's in the band goes, his dick is big, his dick is very big. And he's like, I got a dick, blah, blah, blah. And then he starts naming how massive his dick is.
You know what? There's just one band. You just nailed the other. Just get rid of the others and just say this.
Oh, my God. I've got to find them now because I really want to play the and then the Go Bananas one is like, go bananas, go bananas. They're hilarious. And their videos are what make their songs. So you're going to get to see the video, but I'm going to play. I'm struggling to find, what did I say? It was Skibbity. There we go.
Skibbity.
Right. Skibbity biddy bit. Right. Okay. Everyone else is going to have to search for this themselves.
Okay, so there's a man dancing and a cock on screen. Rooster, sorry. Oh, that's creepy.
A little baby,
dancing in it. Okay. What on earth? This is like a fever dream, everyone,
yeah,
okay?
Yeah, all of their videos are like this.
They're quite obviously... clear that they are just nuts. They obviously know that they need to just they're having fun, but yeah, okay, no, right. That's
right. Anyway, do you would like to know how many views that's got?
4.8 million.
698 million views.
So popular then.
They're popular, believe it or not. Yep.
And we'll have them as a guest next week.
Next week. So let's see if we can name some of their songs. There's one here called Pendejo. That's a good one. His face has been superimposed onto her body.
Oh, that's...
So he's singing on her body there.
Their dreams are... their dreams? Their videos are basically fever dreams. Someone has stuck so many mushrooms down their throat and then they're just going, let's make a video on what I see.
Yeah, it's great. Honestly... that if you just got to get, this sounds terrible, but just get part of the fact that they're Russian. If that's going to be an issue for you, then you don't want to be able to look at them at all. But yeah, they are Hypno Dancer. That's a good one. Go Bananas, I've said. Yeah, there's loads that are really funny. But you have to watch the videos with them. You've got to watch the videos with them. That's what makes them.
Fine. Well, you know what? We've done lots of talking.
Missed the point.
Well, no, you did. I think you actually got the point at the very end. And that is all that matters. Yeah. Oh, this sodding god.
Let's play some games.
Yeah, let's do Do You Remember?
Yeah.
Because mine is music related.
Oh, wicked.
So it kind of fits in.
Hooray! Segway.
Do you remember the shit that I bought? Remember? Did you give it a thought? Remember? It's probably tat, that's all. Woo!
Hello again. Again, we are here for the ASMR Do You Remember? With your host, Rob. I'm over on this side. Now I'm over on this side.
We don't do stereo, Rob.
I'm in mono.
So I've just whispered into your both ears. You tit.
Anyway, right, here we are. Do you remember? Last week, I brought alien eggs.
You did
got one
alien
on your
eggs.
Desks, for God's sake. so I failed. So I've brought sweets that you have in a jar and,
what? And
by the door, because I brought the polos when we were on the
yes, you had
the jar, and they were alien eggs, which you had on your desk.
Yep.
So maybe I'm just finding things that you own.
Yeah, you're subconsciously seeing things I own.
Today I brought a Jurassic Park poster. Oh, shit.
Well, as I said, my Do You Remember is musically related. So it actually fit in with what we were just talking about. I don't know what yours is. And I think I went first last week. So
I think you actually did go first. But last week you brought Space Beast Inc. You didn't get a point either because I'd never heard of it.
Correct.
So we're 7-all.
We are 7-0.
We also might have a delivery from Prison Pigeon, but we'll see.
Yep. So go on, you go first.
I'm going to go first. I've got a bit of story with this one, but I'm going to grab it first and I'll tell you the story. I'm going to get away from the microphone.
So he's rummaging his W.H. Smith bag, something that's becoming rarer on the high street because of their stupid price. It's Sea Spunkies.
Yay.
Hi, Sea Monkeys.
It's Sea Monkeys.
I'm not going to give you a point.
Oh, for God's sake. I've got one at work and I've been growing them for the last week.
No, South Park episode. Watched it about 3 days ago. They get sea monkeys. They get sperm and put in the sea monkeys and it makes a sea monkey race. They then pour them into the teacher's cup of tea and she dies. And the news report is that they found semen in her stomach.
Mm-hmm.
So they think they've killed her by mistake when actually what that just means is she sucks off Mr. Mackey, and that's what was found in her stomach.
Oh, I'm going to have to watch that episode then.
It's a very good episode. But these, fun story. Okay, so we bought them 1 year, me and my mate Eddie. We went on a school trip. We were the cool kids. We were in chemistry club. But it did mean you did get some bonuses out of that. For example, one day near summer, we got to leave school early and we went to the science museum for half a day.
Yep.
No educational need. We just went and played and had fun.
The science museum is brilliant.
He bought those at the science museum. And we got home and they were fine. And then he decided, they're not very lively. Let's give them an oxygenating tablet. So they're what you use with fish tanks, if you don't know. You drop a very specific amount of them in per something like 50 litres of water.
Yeah.
And it helps oxygenate the water and get it ready. He dropped like four tablets into their little plastic house they had.
Tiny,
and it was like almost like one of those volcano exercises you see where you do baking powder and vinegar. It just and then all these little corpses floating up to the top where they basically just lived in an environment of near on pure oxygen.
So I had a few of these growing up, and they never lived for me. They never grew up. And the one time I got them to grow up, you don't have to do anything with them. They just, for whatever reason, mine just didn't.
Well, I think almost 100% of the time, they don't work because kids don't follow the instructions. They don't want to fill it up with water, put the preparation powder in, leave it 48 hours, and then come back and put the sea monkeys in. They want it to do it then and there and wake up in the morning and there be, like the picture, these friendly little things waving at you with castles.
Yeah.
What they really don't know is they're brine shrimp.
Yeah.
They are boring as fuck.
Yeah.
And they take a few days to hatch. And if you don't prep the water, they don't hatch.
Yeah. And the thing, I finally had them to hatch and a friend come round and he lifted it up by the lid and spilt it.
All their little corpses in the carpet.
This is my bedroom, and I was really actually quite upset by it because I think it might have been the third or fourth time I'd ever had them, and
I finally got them to grow. Oh,
and
no.
They killed them all. Yeah. So the funny story about this is I bought this on eBay.
Yeah.
I had looked on Amazon, but it was more expensive, so I just went to eBay. Never added it to my basket. Nothing. And I said to you, didn't I, that I got an Amazon parcel, and this was in the Amazon parcel.
Okay.
My name on it, everything.
Yes, yeah, okay.
And I was like, this is weird, this has come from Amazon, because I ordered it on eBay. And it had a gift receipt inside it, labelled to someone's granddad, with loads of names and stuff
very
on it as well.
Very weird.
And it's very, but what makes the story interesting is yesterday, because I've had this for a few days, yesterday I got an email from eBay saying, we've just dispatched your sea monkeys.
So maybe you're going to get more sick.
So either
that is really weird.
Either they're just their system's really slow, which is quite likely.
Very possible. I still think they drop shipped it. Because the other thing, so just to very quickly explain, drop shipping, you can set up an account on this web page. There's several of them now. You choose your items from Amazon you want to sell. And what happens is it then automatically lists on eBay for you. It uses their images. And when someone buys it on eBay, it goes off to Amazon and orders it and sends it straight to their house, uses your bank details. And basically, you just up the price on eBay. So you say, if Amazon's selling it at £4, increase it by 50%, so £6. That's how you get your profit out of it. And then
you don't do anything,
basically, except for watch the web page and adjust the prices. And there are a couple out there that you can say, when the price is this, sell it. And as soon as it changes, take it off. So I wonder if they drop shipped it. Because you said, oh, yeah, but I looked and it was more money on Amazon than it was on eBay.
Amazon, yeah.
There must have been a day where it wasn't.
Yeah.
So that's all I can think of. Unless it's such a big eBayer that they're using Amazon as their stocker.
Yeah. It's just very odd that I got... But it's just the gift receipt thing threw me.
Yeah. Did you check if it... because Amazon's got a couple of web stores.
No. Yeah, it's just a name, just a person. It's just weird. A weird person, yeah.
It was who very works odd. At Amazon Warehouse and steals things. Oh,
I said that
things.
To Randall. I wonder if this person works at Amazon, they've just put my name on it.
Very odd.
Yeah,
they
just gone in and used an Amazon box and did use their print machine to get the free postage. And they actually did get it on eBay.
Can you imagine if they did that?
I reckon they'd get caught. I think Amazon. I know a few people that work in the warehouse in there.
You couldn't get away with it.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't even go for a piss, apparently. So.
Yeah, apparently not.
Can I just point out, it's not as weird as receiving a pen that says, yeah, Alexa, turn off all the lights, and no one actually telling me or owning up to who sent it to me.
Let's have a look.
So I'm a little bit creeped out at this point.
Oh, sorry, microphone.
Sorry, I'm not sure about that.
Alexa, shut up.
Did it turn your... Did you actually read out loud?
Yeah, I just said it out loud. And oh, he's broken the pen.
Guys, is that pretending
you
that
tits.
It was
he's unscrewed it. It's not got a crack in it or something, okay?
Yeah, I was looking for...
I had checked.
Yeah. Yeah, way so ahead of you on that one.
No one has admitted to sending this to me, so I'm a little bit creeped out because there's only a couple of people that know my address. So... What I'm hoping it might be this pen company trying to do some weird viral marketing, come back to us and order the pens from us in the future. So what they've done is they've gone to channel84.co.uk. They've checked the who is registrant details, which is me and this home address, because obviously I don't have a business address to put it anywhere. And they've just got the address from there, maybe. I don't know. But
I mean, that's quite a stretch. But at the same time, no one's owning up to it.
Exactly. So it's a little bit weird. So, you don't get a point.
No, but I'm having a pen.
I might get a point on this. Wow, this was actually really good condition. Now, I love the fact that when you go on eBay, sometimes you'll buy something really expensive and it turns up in the world's worst packaging and it ends up coming damaged. Mm-hmm. Yet, I order a CD single of a song that no one wants. No one wants it. And it turned up in a cardboard box, covered in bubble wrap, another layer of bubble wrap to keep it protected. I mean, it was properly packaged. But I give you Perfect Day, The Children in Need, BBC terrible version of the song. God. Where you got lots of celebrities trying to basically do another Do They Know It's Christmas, but with Perfect Day instead. Which...
It's such a perfect day.
I'm glad I spent it with you.
Yeah, you get a point, obviously.
It's a great song by the original artist. It was not a great song by the people the BBC chose.
Oh, this is bad.
Oh, no.
The original version, the 3 minutes 46...
Yeah.
The female-only version...
Right.
...is 3 minutes 44. But the male-only version is 3 minutes 48. More airtime. Where's the equality? Take that back. I don't want it anywhere near me. You get a point. Move on.
Nice. Okay, so that makes it 8-7 to me then, yeah, with a terrible, terrible, terrible thing.
I don't like that song, by the way.
I like the original. The original I like. The BBC.
I do not like that. That no, version of it.
It's not good.
I didn't like it then, don't like it now.
It's got the woman we were joking about earlier with What Have You Done Today? Well, I can't even think of what her name is and how she sings now. But our impression of Boyzone and
yeah,
her,
yeah,
she's on there as well doing the same sort of... She always does. I love her music, don't get me wrong, but it is a very distinctive song. Cool, okay. I got a point. Ha, 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 ha. Oh, fuck. Hello, prick.
Oh, get off. dickhead. Use the landing strip for
the next time
arsehole.
That pigeon lands or touches that microphone and makes all that lovely noise for me to edit out, I'm going to shove a firework up its arsehole and send it back to the moon.
It's because he's on by the window.
Well, if he came through the fucking door, it would be better.
Yeah, well,
I know he doesn't have opposable thumbs.
Would you want anyway, you fucking prick? Oh, Sam's brought us something, has he? All right, Sam. Who's Sam?
Right, so
Killer Rabbit Pod.
Sam from Killer Rabbit Pod,
because we know who he is.
Or Mule on good old Twitter has brought to us a TV show, and it's not one I've thought about, but it's definitely one I remember. It is MC Hammer in Hammer Time.
In Hammer Time?
Yes, he did a TV series. Sorry, not Hammer Time. Hammer Man. Yeah, he had a children's TV show. It lasted 13 episodes, and it was called Hammer Man. It is just as shit as you expect it to
be. I've had no idea.
Yeah, you have. As soon as you see it,
I'm going to look it up now because I want to make sure that I'm. Don't
look it
steal
up,
a point from
and I'm
you.
Telling you, you will recognise it, and you'll
Hammer
go, "Oh God."
91-92, MC Hammer, Clark Johnson.
Oh God, dead air. No,
dead air. Oh, I remember it. Oh,
yes,
gross.
There you go.
It's gross, isn't it?
It was terrible. It wasn't well animated. and let's face it, Hammer Time wasn't exactly that good a song, but I'm basing an entire TV series on that.
Would you like me to read? It's on IMDb. The poster's in German. You'd like me to read it to you, since you want to have
no,
good from last
God,
week.
No,
my
no,
German
no, no,
was.
No, 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 no. Sam, you get a point.
Well done, Sam.
I think that's his second point.
3.9 out of 10 on IMDb.
That's generous.
More episodes than Puddington Peas.
Is it?
13 episodes.
Oh,
Puddington
no.
Peas. Did you say it was 8? Did you say or 9 or something?
I thought it was 13.
Was it a 13 as well? Or is that the magic number then? Are we saying, well, if because we said 30, well, I didn't say it because it's not something I would have said. You lot said it, you all insane people. The 13 episode was the perfect amount
it.
Of episodes. They hit perfection.
Hang
so does
on,
that
no,
mean.
No one said that.
No, I think it might have been one of the KRP guys said
didn't
it.
Win.
Didn't KR, one of the KRP, it might have been Sam that even said it. Sorry, Sam, if you didn't. And if this has done 13 episodes, by that logic, this is as good as Puddington Peas.
I'm not answering. I'm not even going to dignify you with an answer, you whingy little bitch.
Let's do Hammer.
You're a whingy little bitch. Stop it. Just because Pokemon did not win.
I want Hammer Man to go up against Puddington Peas in the next round.
Well, it's not even on the list, so fuck you, dickhead. Jesus fucking Christ. He's never going to get over this, is he, boys and girls?
No.
Prick. So, Rob, I understand it's been a hard time for you this week. A loss in the family is never fun.
No, it's not been great. It's been difficult.
Especially when...
I only saw him an hour before. I'd only just made him tea and played with him. And he just...
Beep, beep, beep.
Just died. Well, I don't know what noise he made because I fucking muted it.
And that might be why he died, boys and girls. If you hadn't guessed, we're talking about Tamagotchi. Oh, fucking cough.
If you follow us on Twitter. We posted, didn't we? Something on Twitter?
We did. We asked who was more likely to kill theirs the most.
Oh, there was a vote. Yeah.
You and T apparently were most likely to kill theirs the most.
Oh, of course.
What we then discovered was how hard work and how high maintenance these bloody things
They're
are.
Needy little
so,
fuckers.
So, yours died how many days?
5 days.
It was not five
days. Yeah, 5 years. 5 years, a year a day.
Oh, was it five?
Yeah, yeah, because yours was nine. Yours lasted 9 years.
Yeah, yeah.
Yours was 9 years old.
Mine got to nine. Jasper, he grew up. He grew up into the bad health, bad boy of evolution. If you look at their little tree of evolution. Mm-hmm. And boy, did that little prick let you know. Every morning I'd wake up and there was a double shit waiting for me to wash it away, followed by a skull that I had to inject him with narcotics to keep him alive. I'd then feed him, play games with him, and even then the little miserable bastard wasn't happy, so I'd discipline him, and eventually we'd get to happy. And just like you, literally, checked him, happy, full of food, half discipline, bopping away like his freaky little self. Looked at my monitor, 10 minutes later, looked... He was up with Jesus.
Mine's an atheist, so he's still there. I mean, rotting on my kitchen counter.
Mine's still flying away.
Yeah, I haven't got the heart to press the button. Severo's ghost is still there on mine.
Yeah, Jasper's ghost is still here on mine. Yeah. 9 years old.
So you won.
Oh, I did win, but I was trying hard by the end not to, and then I kept on feeling bad that I hadn't fed or washed him, so I'd quickly go and feed and wash him.
I like you feel guilty. It's just a computer program. That means
I found a cheat though.
What's the cheat?
So to make him happy, all I would do, I'd get the Tamagotchi, I'd get to the game and set the game and start the game. Then I would turn it upside down, I'd put my finger on the B button, the middle button. And for 5 minutes, all I would do was sit there banging away the B button, not even looking at the screen. Because what I turned out to find out is in that game, more often than not, it's 3 versus 2 in the direction. And if you just keep doing this for about 5 minutes, you'll end up with a full happy bar every time.
That's how I did it too. I just sat there because I would do it. Say I was in a traffic jam and I'd be sat in a lot of traffic. Not doing that. I just opened up, just press the button.
Can you imagine? Hang on. Can you pull over, turn your engine off, please, sir?
Yeah.
I'm going to give you 3 points because due care and attention, and you were... Okay, well, I can't say you were using your phone, but you were using your Tamagotchi.
Yeah, using your Tamagotchi. I got in trouble with Mark at work once, didn't we? Do you remember this? Because we were playing Pokemon.
No.
We were meant to be cooking in the kitchen, the pub.
Oh,
so
dear.
It's back when we had the foldable ones. Were they the SPs? Game Boys?
Oh, yeah.
And you
had
to have the cable connecting them, I think.
Right.
No, it's just after cable. And you had to, maybe you had to point at each other. But we were battling. And, the boss come in and we both had our Game Boys out there and he went nuts.
Ooh.
Yeah, got a lot of trouble for that. Never mind.
Bad boy, Robert.
But the thing is, the guy he made the assistant manager tell us off, and that was Jane. And Jane just found it funny.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me.
She's like, I'm here to tell you off. You know you shouldn't have been doing that. Yeah, I know I shouldn't be doing that. Let's just pretend I've told you off. Okay.
Yes. Thanks, Jane. Bye.
This was the problem that a lot of the managers had. We were all mates.
We were. Absolutely.
And
thick as thieves.
We all hated that. I'm not going to name who the guy was, but the manager at that time.
Oh, I am.
We did not like him. He was not a nice guy.
Well, he robbed the pub.
Didn't he steal those steaks? Because he was stealing steaks and was trying to blame it on Chris.
He nicked steaks, allegedly. Just
allegedly.
And he also allegedly misused pub funding to pay for courses to do himself that were nothing to do with the pub.
Didn't he do like magician stuff or something?
He was a magician and Elvis impersonator and karaoke singer.
What's his partner? It was lovely.
Oh, she was lovely.
She was lovely. Nothing wrong. We took her clubbing once into Watford, and she was used to doing the proper clubs where you'd be like high vis clothes and fluffy.
And she
went dressed like that, and we took her to Watford. She loved it there, though. She was up on the stage,
I'm
bit
just
dancing.
She was gorgeous.
Oh, she's very pretty, yeah, but she was really fun.
The reason I bring it up, she was really fun. She was gorgeous. Well, he wasn't. He was a short, squat Jack Russell of a man, basically.
Not a nice
short,
man
short
either,
person.
He wasn't a nice man either. Well,
I remember one evening, I've got a film upstairs, TJ. Do you want to have some beers and watch a film? I've got nothing else to do. So I went upstairs and we watched a film. And we watched The Village, which...
Yeah.
Is possibly one of the shittest films I've
it's
watched.
It's not a film to ask someone.
We got 15 minutes in, and his girlfriend came in, semi-dressed. The idea would have been, I've been waiting for you in the bedroom. Oh, I'm guessing you're not coming to the bedroom anymore. Now, if that had been me...
I'd have been like, you leave.
Yeah. Bye. Yeah, be with you now, darling.
Yeah.
No, we're watching a film. And just shut her down, and it's like, really?
Yeah, weird.
I mean, I'm single at the moment. I'll take one for the team if I have to.
You're single at the time, yeah.
But it was just, hey, odd man.
He was odd chap. So I was in the service station the other day, TJ.
Of course you were.
To go, and they had two drinks in there that I thought were I've never seen before.
Okay.
And I thought, I'm going to grab those drinks and I want TJ to have a taste of them. And also, well, I just stopped at that one stop, as I always did. And I've taken something that I want you to look at them and you tell me what you think they are. And then I'll tell you what I think. But I think you're going to say the same thing if you haven't already seen my bag.
So okay. Let me just grab them. Right. I'm going to give you these cups to decant your drinks into.
Right, so here they are. What do you think they are, TJ?
I would have said they're packing peanuts.
That's exactly what I thought they were, because they feel like it too.
They look like some sort of corn puff crisp.
Yeah, I think they're some kind of crisp. I mean, it's got nutritional information on them.
Cardboard has nutrition.
They were on a thing all on their own in the food section.
I mean, you could use those to package an eBay item.
Oh, definitely. That's what they look like, but a bit yellower. So they're called Gusto. Gusto. There's a very cute dog on there with a little one of those straw hats that you'd get in the olden days.
Yeah,
down
he looks
the beach.
Like he should belong in Top Cat.
It's clearly from somewhere else because I don't even know what language that is. Is it French?
There's an ampersand. Throw it over.
Well, an ampersand would be German, wouldn't it?
Polish, I think.
It's Polish.
Note Romanian. The first instruction on it is R-O. That is a Romanian.
Right. Well, oh God, I've just stole that.
Produced by. Oh, produced by. produced. Oh yeah, Romania. Produced in Romania.
Okay, so the two drinks are brought. I like to call these the competing brands, Tango and Fanta. I think these two are fighting for the same shelf space.
Okay.
Tango, dark berry.
Yeah.
Sugar-free. And Fanta, it has a big question mark, limited edition, hashtag what the Fanta, strawberry cheesecake.
Ooh.
So, it's a weird one. I thought you had to, like, guess the flavor. Do you remember they had those Cadbury's to guess the flavor?
Well, there were some Fantas that did that as well. You had to guess the flavor. And I think the Jeep Show Boys did it. One of them was Blue Raz plus something else.
Well, I wonder if that's what these were, but now they're actually telling you what it is. Because it is like a big question. You can see the pad, it's a big question mark. But then it says what it is underneath. So what would you like to go for? I think the dark berry would be a good palate cleanser because I think this strawberry cheesecake is going to be gross.
Yeah, okay. Well, let's go for strawberry cheesecake first. Apologies for all the clicking. Rob keeps on hitting the cable on this one.
Sorry,
and it's making
it...
loads of crackling noises.
Oh, is it? Sorry, because I haven't got headphones, have I? So I don't know.
No, I must order a headphone splitter so you can hear.
So I never know if I'm making all these funny noises. Sorry, guys. Well, they might not know because your wonderful editing skills.
We'll see.
Although, you know why? It's because that's moved.
Yeah, I don't know if that's the boom mic that I normally... the boom stand I normally use or not. We'll work it out. Okay. Hang on. That's weird.
Oh, it stinks. It's really
It smells
quite
of cake.
Horrible.
It immediately smells of cheesecake.
It smells like cheesecake, definitely. So it's what's it meant to be? Strawberry cheesecake. It does smell like cheesecake. I don't really like cheesecake. So
oh, you see, I love a good non-baked cheesecake. I do one that will make you see through time the amount of sugar in there. You use like two whole Terry's chocolate oranges in it, a dark Terry's chocolate orange, so much sugar, and a mascarpone.
Isn't it a funny colour? Doesn't it look like a bit like dishwater?
It looks like Grimace has jizzed in a cup. For those of you that know what... In fact, that could actually be what Grimace's jizz smells like.
No, I think Grimace's... Well, certainly the texture would be a lot thicker.
True.
I kind of almost think it would be lumpy.
Oh, I like the
Do you know
lumps.
What I mean? Like, a bit like porridge.
Yeah, I don't even
That's
want
what
think.
I think it but like purple Just, porridge.
You've seen the Meat Canyon video of the Grimace and the McRib and whole things then.
Yeah, I think you said it to me.
Yeah, Okay, Rob's going for a drink. Down in one. No, he's given up.
You've got to actually taste it.
Oh dear.
I'm pulling a face.
He is pulling a face. Right, I'm going to go for my taste. Oh, that's gross.
Isn't it not nice at all, is it?
Oh, that's...
It does not taste anything like it smells.
I tell you what that tastes like.
I don't know what it tastes like. Oh, it's on the back of my tongue. It's on the back of my tongue.
Natural yogurt. It tastes like if you've had a spoon from the unflavoured natural yogurt. That kind of bitterness that hits the back of your tongue.
It's making my teeth feel funny.
Oh, that's.
Well, I'm going to finish the cup because we've got more.
Well, I'm going to neck it, but I'm not impressed with you at this point, Rob. I'm pretty upset. I think this is possibly the worst thing we've put in our mouth on the show.
Oh, I don't like that at all, TJ.
No. I couldn't even. It's worse than medicine. It's. Have you ever had day nurse? It's worse than day nurse.
Night nurse.
Oh,
so they have it, weren't it?
Okay. No.
Apparently, this is 2 servings, so we're doing the right thing by sharing it between us. Okay. Well, what was the lowest rating? 2, wasn't it?
2.4, wasn't it?
2.4. This is the bottom of the bottom. This is the worst thing we've tried in the whole of the existence of this show.
That is 2. I'd rather drink your piss, Rob.
2, I'd rather go... 2, I'd rather drink a drip tray, which I've done.
Oh.
And I can tell you, yeah, the grit present in a drip tray is nicer than the things that we do when we're drunk, eh? Yeah. Yeah. This,
No. Just... Yeah, full stop. No, that's going down the drain.
I'm sorry, I'm not actually going to finish that. That's wasteful. I'm not going to be able to finish it. It's so disgusting. Can we try a packing kernel?
Yeah, go for it. You open those up, and I'm just going to open up this parcel from Karen because I completely forgot we had this. Or should we save that for the next episode?
No, I want to see what it is.
Well, we'll see what it is, but we'll taste it in the next episode.
Yeah, okay.
Sorry about the very random drop in here. Karen, I must apologise. We opened up your parcel and we completely missed the letter. Now, I've got no idea how we managed to miss a bright pink piece of paper, so let me read the letter to all of you now before we jump back in with me and Rob last night. Dear TJ and Rob, as promised, here is my taste test candidate, the Dido Bar. I found them in my local Turkish supermarket, who, by the way, always have the nicest fresh flatbreads on the countertop, and baklava that is too yummy to resist. I'm sure they are in part responsible for my flubbery bits. I feel you. I feel you on that one, Karen. Apologies in advance for any feelings of, oh dear, I don't want to put this in my mouth, or internal jukebox issues plus white flag on repeat. I hope the bars leave you with less of a bad taste in your mouth than your ex-girlfriend. Thanks, Karen. Thanks. And as you'll hear in a minute, we kind of cover that bit. Keep up the excellent content. All the best. Patron saint of the pod, Karen. P.S. I'm off to Amsterdam soon, so goodies may follow. And there's a lovely little one wonky halo for a terrible saint. Love it. Thank you so much for the stuff, Karen. But anyway, join me and Rob, and we'll talk about that again as well. Now.
I'm going to taste one of these.
Okay, so I'm opening it up, and oh, okay, no, it's not a. I thought it was a. Hi guys, I've intercepted Karen's parcels. It include Okay, nice. So Adam sent the parcel.
I'd say just a second. I don't think this is food.
So we could do a new Netflix series. You know they've got Is It Cake? Is it food?
I don't think, CJ, you've got to try. I don't think it's food.
Hang on, I will. Let me. So, Adam very kindly posted the parcel for Karen.
Right.
And there's a post-it. Hi, guys. I've intercepted Karen's parcel to include potential emergency do you remembers. Disclaimer, unopened and uninspected charity shop gamble. It sounds like it could be shit from the description, except Sir David. Cheers, Adam. Well, it's a £1 item. Bric-a-brac, and it's Sir David Frost. Hang on. Oh, yeah, Sir David. Okay, yeah. Sir David Frost hosts Remember When audio quiz game. Nostalgia is a funny thing. Ask yourself what you did last Tuesday, and you'd probably find it tough to recall. Some things, though, just stick in your mind. Welcome to Remember When, the audio quiz. Now, if you remember when it took 5 minutes for the TV to warm up, when 50p was considered a good amount of pocket money, and summers were all about bike rides, hula hoops, and climbing trees, then this game is for you. 9 uniquely retro audio quiz games to test your memory of everything. This actually might be quite fun.
Yeah, we could do that in an episode.
Yeah, we will do
that Halloween next. Maybe we'll do the one after.
Yeah, that sounds good. Thank you very much, Adam.
Thanks, Adam.
But going back into the parcel then, because I'm sure it was meant to be a... Oh, it is. Oh, it's chocolate bars.
Oh, thank God for that. I've just eaten a load of what I think is polystyrene.
Oh, hello. Oh, that was yours.
It's now floor chocolate.
Dido. For fuck's sake, it's Dido. Why have you sent me Dido, Karen? Karen? Why have you sent me Dido?
Oh, we can't eat it now.
It's white fag. Right, this is Dido Gold.
He's rocking in the corner.
Tugna. It basically looks like a foreign version of a Kit Kat Chunky.
She's just been away.
Yes, she has.
Is this from Dam?
This is very possible, I guess. Yes, that could well be. But basically, it looks like a gold caramel version of a Kit Kat Chunky with a creamy filling. I don't want to talk about Dido and creamy filling.
Is it?
I'm so upset.
Now, has she purposely done that? Because she's that's hilarious. Genius.
I'm sure.
Absolute genius.
I'm going to be messaging her after this recording and I will be finding out. But, okay.
Absolute genius.
We will save those for the next taste test. I think we'll have that at
just
the Halloween one,
shall
we?
Doing a translate on that to see what does that actually say.
Okay, well, while you do that.
Tastes like milk jam. Dido
like
milk
gold. Jam.
The white flag that tastes like milk jam.
Milk jam. I mean,
that's what it says, mate.
It's an interesting. Right, I'm going to have a gusto. Let's try this.
This is it's Turkish, apparently.
I'm going to have a puffaletti. Apparently, that's what these pecking peanuts are called.
It's the texture. It's the texture. They just disappear.
It just collapses in on itself. Where's the flavour?
It's just nothing. It's just nothing.
These are unflavoured polystyrene chips.
Are we sure that it's...
I just realised what I said. When I got my packing peanuts. Yeah, they're bacon flavour.
I don't think it's food.
So you buy them...
It disappears.
And you get a satisfying one crunch, and then suddenly it just goes like you're cocking
weird,
the cold
it
weather. It suddenly turns into a little turtle and disappears.
Oh, I need to get a photo of it. It's ridiculous. It's so weird.
Those are. They're just. They're not nice.
Well, they don't taste of anything.
No, they don't.
I'm going to have two at once to see.
Well, one up each nostril.
It's like nothing.
No, they just that is weird.
They disintegrate. You don't swallow anything. Where does it go? It's like those things you put in your cheeks when you're at the dentist.
Yes. I don't like those, Rob. So really,
2 point, is it food?
Yeah, 2 point, is it food? I'm happy with that because you really upset me this. You just, no.
Well, I do have a Tango Dark Berry that could save the day.
Right, well, we need to be quick on this one because we still got the Nostalgic Kids knockout to do.
Let's save that. We'll have that with a Dido.
Oh, we're going to have that with Dido.
Let's have
we?
That with Dido. And I'll have my odd tasting Lilt.
Yeah, fair enough. I'm going to have some Cherry Coke. You know what time it is? It's the Channel 84 Variety Nostalgic Kids Show knockout. Insert Rob laughing.
Yay.
Okay, last week we had Group H Animaniacs versus the Raggy Dolls, and Animaniacs won, much to my chagrin, but I kind of accept that one. I'm not like Rob, who will take this on for weeks and weeks and weeks after Pokemon lost. And then we had D'Artagnan versus the Demon Headmaster, and quite obviously the terrible acting of the Demon Headmaster won. So, whether you agree or not, tough, we chose. So we came on to Group I, and we had in match A, or match one of Group I, Dinosaurs. So that was the attempted comedic kids sitcom with people wearing giant dinosaur suits. Dinosaurs.
Yeah, it's really good.
Versus Danger Mouse.
It's
an incredibly hard one for me, this one.
Sorry, I'm still picking packing kernel out of my teeth.
So I grew up with the original Danger Mouse. I do remember watching Dinosaurs. I don't know what channel it ended up coming to. I think it was a BBC show for me, but it was broadcast elsewhere before the BBC got hold of it.
It was, imagine The Simpsons, because essentially it was a bit of a Mick take of The Simpsons.
Yes, absolutely. It was
the characters were what The Simpsons
had done. They decided we're going to do a dinosaur version.
Yeah, imagine if The Simpsons were dinosaurs, because mixed, it even had the fat dad, the tall mum,
mixed in with a little bit of Roseanne.
Mm. Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's as if Roseanne and The Simpsons had dinosaur sex.
Yeah. Quite sexy, I'll look that up later.
there's another one for you.
So that was, yeah.
After you finish with Lower Decks.
So that was Dinosaurs, and that was 1991 to 1994. They didn't get that many episodes from what I saw.
And they probably ended it too.
Oh, 65. It did get an ending. Have you ever seen the final episode?
I have seen it. It's quite sad.
It's the most depressing.
Yeah, sad.
Oh, Flintstones as well. Throw the Flintstones into the mix as well for what the dynamics of the family were. Yeah, basically... The dad saying, well, it's the end of the world, guys. We're all going to die shortly. Oh, I love my family, though.
And
we're all going to be here together. And then that's the end of it.
Yeah, they need you all.
It's a real brutal ending for a kids' TV show. But I kind of think it fitted more with one of these, again, like The Simpsons, I guess. Adults... It was designed for adults as well as children, with a lot put in for adults, so they knew that they could sit back and watch it and the kids would enjoy it as well. So family viewing, I guess. A little bit less risque than The Simpsons, because I've been going through The Simpsons recently because Kay wants to watch it. And I watched like 4 or 5 episodes in a row and thought, not one of these I really want to show Kay, because I don't want to be explaining what this or this is at this point in her life. I didn't realise actually quite how... adult it could be.
Some of it can be,
so this was a lot less adult than The Simpsons Dinosaurs. Moving over to Danger Mouse then. Thoughts?
I did watch it, but I did not watch it religiously. I know this is what's going to win this. I can't see Dinosaurs winning. Even though I would pick it. Danger Mouse, I mean, just even the voice actors.
Well, David Jason to start with, absolutely. What's really interesting as well, I've watched the new Danger Mouse that they've released recent years.
I've not seen any of the new one.
It's amazing. It's exactly like you remember the old Danger Mouse.
Oh, it's got Alexander Armstrong.
Yeah, it's just a little bit updated, but otherwise it looks pretty much the same and the stories are pretty much the same. It's as insane and weird as it ever was. They didn't try and update the show. They just kind of carried it on.
Just bringing up the correct versions so we can see who's it. Yes, yeah, so David Jason, yeah.
It's just, it's hard not to go with Danger Mouse here. Terry Scott as Penfold, for example.
There he is.
I probably watched Danger Mouse more.
Yeah, but I watched Dinosaurs more, and I'm going to say Dinosaurs. Because I watched that more, basically. I remember both of these just as fondly as each other, but I watched Dinosaurs more. But I can't. If you pick Danger Mouse, I can't see Danger Mouse not going through.
So I probably watched more Danger Mouse because it was on more as I grew up until Dinosaurs turned up. I would say I would go for Dinosaurs because I watched it more with heart than I would have watched Danger Mouse. Danger Mouse I watched because it was on and it was part of just kids' TV at the time, and I would sit there glued to the TV and watch whatever shows were on because that's all we really had. Whereas I would choose to stop what I'm doing to watch Dinosaurs.
I was going to say the exact same thing, yeah.
And, of course, that means we piss off the Twitter poll because...
They blatantly... Probably
well, 100%. You've got the scores in front of you.
Oh, I do have the scores in front of me. Yeah, 61.5 to 38.5. This half person's voting again.
So, yeah, 2/3 went with Danger Mouse, which I can kind of understand, but this is really going on what we kind of choose here, I'm afraid. What I would be intrigued to do is, if I copy all of these and just do it with the scores set by Twitter, what the result would be versus what our result is.
Yeah.
So I will redo all of these. And
that's
then
only
going
to work for the first round, though.
No, do it because then I'll put the other rounds up for...
No, but when we go... But for example, Danger Mouse for us hasn't gone through. So, oh, you know, you'd have to pick them up.
Yeah, I'll put polls up for all of them. It's fine.
Yeah, okay.
So yeah, no, I'm going to go with dinosaurs on that one. So out of the 13 votes, people went Danger Mouse over dinosaurs. But coming on to then...
But dinosaurs go through.
Yeah, dinosaurs go through. This was incredibly easy. It's either the trapdoor or Rainbow. Now, Rainbow has got an absolute kick-ass soundtrack. Soundtrack, theme song. It's hard to say it's a soundtrack when you've got Rod, Jane and fucking Freddy singing at everything. It's got the piss take episode they did for the Christmas tapes of one skin, two skin, three, four skin. Yeah. We all play with our twangers. But it's not the trapdoor.
It's not a trapdoor.
The trapdoor is just... It's legendary status, and it's stop motion, the voice acting, the theme song as well. Yeah, let's face it, don't you go open that trap door. There's something down there.
It's so good.
Boom. I can't imagine anything beating the trap door, to be honest.
No.
Especially out of all the ones we've done so far. And Twitter actually agrees with us on this. 58.8% went with trap door. 41.2% went with Rainbow. So
it was
actually,
quite close, though.
It was closer than Dinosaurs versus Danger Mouse. And there were more votes on that one, 17 votes in this case.
It's a trapdoor, definitely.
The trapdoor has to win there.
It's one of the few out of all of them that we've done so far I do actually watch on YouTube.
Yeah, I've rewatched them. I've got the DVD somewhere from there, from it, because it's one of those classic bits of British TV. The original Wallace and Gromit, A Grand Day Out, all those sort of things live in one space in my mind, and they will not be beaten by anything else.
Yeah.
And the trapdoor is up there. I mean, you could have put that up with a hell of a lot and it still would have won. Mm-hmm. I think we've got Charlie Chalk coming up at some point. It might be stop animation. It would take a lot of work. But God, even the trapdoor still pisses all over it.
Yeah.
It's just one of those shows that anyone our age would agree with this, I think.
I think so.
I don't think anyone can argue that.
Apart from the 41.2 of a person that doesn't agree with that.
Yeah, I'm interested by that because I genuinely would have thought trapdoor would have got more. But one I would have really been interested in was Sooty versus Rainbow. What would have won then?
I think Sooty. It's tough.
Well, don't forget there's crossover bits in there. There's an episode of Rainbow where Bungle receives an invitation to go to Sooty's birthday party.
Oh, yeah, it was a swinger party.
Yeah, well, two bears, one panda.
So gross.
Oh.
No, is that Fanta still grosser than that?
Yeah, absolutely. That would leave a worse taste in your mouth, Sue. actually, I don't know. Oh, no, I'm not, no.
No, stop.
I don't
right.
want to go into which of them gives a worse taste. Okay, well, the other ones are already up for voting, and you'll find out what those are next time. And before I choke to death, I'm just gonna press stop here for fuck's sake.
Thank you for listening, everybody.
We love you.
How come whenever I start a section, I put a funny voice on?
I really don't know. I think it could be because you're trying to work out what to say, so you're going for, I'll be cute.
I'll be cute. Oh, thank you for listening, everybody.
Please, please accept for what I say.
Please, can you follow me on Twitter? It's not Twitter anymore, it's X. I was thinking of this on
Twitter.
The way.
No, it's Twitter.
I was thinking of this on the way. It's like, we can't keep calling Twitter. And what is, I know that... you people will follow you on Twitter, X, know how much you don't like Elon Musk. But it's a stupid name to call it. It is. Because
it is. It's just because he did SpaceX.
Yeah, but the thing about SpaceX, it's got space first.
Yeah.
So should this be called Social X?
Twitter X.
Twitter X. Yeah, Twitter X. Twitter X. Well, it's X Twitter, isn't it?
Twix, no, that just sounds like a sex app.
Anyway, we're on Twitter, Threads, TikTok, Insta. We're all
Blue
over
Sky.
The place. We're all at Blue Sky, yes.
Which actually, to be honest, is starting to look like that might be the way to go. I've tried Threads, I've got Mastodon, I've got Twitter, I've got TikTok, we've got Insta. It sounds like I've got a long list of horrible, horrible STDs, to be honest, by going through that. I've got Threads, so I've got a bit of thread worms.
I didn't like Threads, you know.
I'm not blown away with it.
The thing about the Twitter, you know, it has the, you know, the for you bit, you know, your following and then the for you or whatever. I just go to following. I don't care what anyone else.
I always go for following. Just,
every now and again, it clicks itself back over. Yeah, nope.
So, nope, back to following.
There's nothing like that in Threads. I don't know how to search for anything in Threads. It gives me just loads of shit.
I kind of get the idea that these ones will expand and get better, but I'm still waiting to see where the vast majority go. So I've hedged my bets. As soon as I've got access codes to get on them, I've got on them, like the Blue Sky invitation code, got onto it, Threads signed up for it, and then whichever one the vast majority abandoned to, which could be any day now, looking at how Twitter is going, or X is going, that's the one we'll end up on, I guess. So kind of follow us on all of them. Go to channel84.co.uk and you can find all our links there as well. Sorry, back to you, Rob.
Yeah, sorry, website, yeah, channel84.co.uk. You can email us on podcasts@channel84.co.uk.
Yes, you can.
And we'll see it, both of us.
We will both see it. So if you send it to podcasts@channel84.co.uk, that is a distribution group, so it will come to Rob and me at the same time. Mm-hmm. If you want to email us directly, and I've been pissing about with Google Workspaces, so we can do this now. You can email tj@channel84.co.uk, and that comes just to me. Or you can send an email to rob@channel84.co.uk, and that will go to just him.
Just me!
So if you want to speak to one of us privately without the other one going, what's going on? Mm-hmm. That's how to do it. Or just DM us on Twitter for the time being. I know Blue Sky hasn't got DMs, which is quite a nice little...
Oh, doesn't it?
No, it doesn't. You can't DM people, which is good.
I think I joined it and then I messaged Cthulhu on it and then that was it.
Nice. We'll probably set up a Discord at some point. I know you've got a Discord account. I had a Discord account, but I can't actually access it because I can't access whatever... Oh, what was it? Oh, that was it. I set up two-factor authentication, lost the backup codes, and Discord's words are, well, sorry, you'll never be able to access that account again. We won't help you.
Oh, that's weird.
Even if I give them the number I registered it with, the email address, it's gone. Sorry, you're done.
Oh, how weird.
It's because I set up an authenticator and then replaced my phone, and I didn't back up the authenticator. It's my fault, but I do think it's a bit shitty that there's no way they will help you.
Yeah.
So I'll just have to create another TJ at Channel 84 Discord account.
Yeah.
So that'll be another profile and people are, it's rubbish. Anyway, sorry, carry on.
Anyway, well, that's it, isn't it? Our emails, podcasts, names, channels, all the other social stuff. I hope you had fun.
Yeah, absolutely. And let us know how you feel about us kind of just doing it in this style. I know we said we weren't going to do it in order, but funny enough, we ended up doing the last three things in order.
In order of our
things
form,
will be a little bit different from now on. And don't forget, the Star Trek episode will be coming next week. So actually, yeah, you will get one next week. But the one that we're recording possibly today, you'll get... Oh, I'm not even going to go into that one. It's just a whole head fuck. Goodbye.
Thank you for listening to the Channel 84 Variety Show. This station is now shutting down and will be back in 2 weeks. Excelsior.